The Laburnum Top, a poem by Ted Hughes. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. In the afternoon yellow September sunlight, a few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen, till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness and a machine starts up, of chitterings and a tremor of wings and trillings. The whole tree trembles and thrills. It is the engine of a family. She stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. Then, with eerie delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite, and the laburnum subsides to empty.
Laburnum, a short tree with hanging branches, yellow flowers and poisonous seeds. Goldfinch, a small singing bird with yellow feathers on its wings.
Page 32. Find out. 1. What laburnum is called in your language? 2. Which local bird is like the goldfinch? Think it out. 1. What do you notice about the beginning and the ending of the poem? 2. To what is the bird's movement compared? What is the basis for the comparison? 3. Why is the image of the engine evoked by the poet? 4. What do you like most about the poem? 5. What does the phrase "her barred face identity mask" mean? Note down. 1. The sound words. 2. The movement words. 3. The dominant color in the poem. List the following. 1. Words which describe sleek, alert, and abrupt. 2. Words with the sound ch as in chart and tr as in trembles in the poem. 3. Other sounds that occur frequently in the poem. Thinking about language. Look for some other poem on a bird or a tree in English or any other language. Try this out. Write 4 lines in verse form on any tree that you see around you. Page 33. Notes. This poem has been placed after text which has references to names of plants for thematic sequencing. Understanding the poem. 1. Glossing of laburnum and goldfinch. 2. Factual understanding. 3. Movement of thought and structuring. For example, poetic sensitivity. 4. Focus on figures of speech and imagery used. For example, poetic sensitivity. 5. Attention to sounds, lexical collocations. For example, poetic sensitivity. Thinking about language. Finding equivalents in other languages, which is known as multilingualism. 2. Relating to thematically similar poems in other languages. 2. Relating to thematically similar poems in other languages. Multilingualism. 3. Attempt at creativity.
You were just listening to this chapter. It was presented by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.